Hello, welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain elastic properties of materials and elastic moduli, which comes under module 2 of engineering physics prescribed by BTU. Here, I am going to discuss the following points. That is, strain hardening, strain softening, Young's modulus, rigidity modulus, bulk modulus, and Poisson's ratio. So here you can look at a graph plotted, that is stress versus strain for an elastic material, and between O and A, the material within elastic limit. That means when you remove the deforming force, the material come back to its original position. So beyond B, it will goes to plastic region. So that's what the curve shows here. So here I am going to explain what is strain hardening and strain softening. Irrespective of the type of deformation that takes place for a body under the action of an external force, Hooke found that stress is always proportional to strain, but only when the deformation is small. Because of small deformation, the molecular displacement will not be too large so that the molecules can return to their previous position once the external force is removed. So this is what the observation made by Hooke. Now if you come to strain hardening, certain materials that are plastically deformed earlier or stressed again show up an increased yield point. This effect is called strain hardening. It is an important industrial process that is used to harden metals or alloys which do not respond to heat treatment. Strain hardening is also referred as, it is the process of making a metal harder by plastic deformation. It is also considered as work hardening. Strain softening. So what is strain softening? For certain metals, such as certain materials, now I am going to explain strain softening. For certain materials such as concrete or soil, the stress strain curve will be typically as shown in the picture. Here, the curve will have negative slope. The negative slope indicates that there is a softening effect of the material over a particular range. This effect is considered as strain softening. Young's modulus, Y is an elastic constant of a material. Young's modulus is the ratio of longitudinal stress to the longitudinal strain within elastic limit. That is, longitudinal stress is nothing but force per area, and longitudinal strain is nothing but change in length to the original length. So force per area means F by A, change in length to original means delta L by L. So the Young's modulus Y is given by FL by A delta L and the Newton, and the unit is Newton per meter square. Next one is rigidity modulus. It is the ratio of shear stress to the shear strain within elastic limit. So rigidity modulus is denoted by symbol N, that is tangential force per area whole divided by lateral displacement between two layers divided by perpendicular distance between the two layers. So rigidity modulus N will be equal to F by A by delta X by X or F by A by theta. So many Newton per meter square. So this is what about rigidity modulus of the material. Next, bulk modulus denoted by symbol K. Bulk modulus is equal to ratio of bulk stress to bulk strain within elastic limit. That is equal to force per area divided by change in volume to the original volume. So force per area is nothing but F by A whole divided by change in volume is delta V and original volume is V. So K is equal to FV by delta V into A. That is equal to PV by delta V. So many Newton per meter square or Pascal. Here P is equal to F by A called bulk pressure. The another concept here, it is Poisson's ratio. So here you can look into this picture. So when a body is subjected to a force or a system of force, the deformation is not only takes place in one direction, but it will take place in all directions. If a wire is stretched, it undergoes extension along the direction of force and also undergoes contraction in the perpendicular direction. The strain produced along the direction of force is called longitudinal strain, and that produced in perpendicular direction is called lateral strain. So here the body is subjected to force. So let capital L is the length of the body. After applying force, L dash is the final length. So change in length is L dash minus L. So the longitudinal strain is nothing but increase in length to the original length. So increase in length is considered as L dash minus L, that is nothing but delta L, and the original length is capital L. Similarly, the diameter of the material changes from small d to d dash. So small d is the original diameter and d dash is the final diameter. So therefore change in diameter, that is d dash minus d. So lateral strain is equal to decrease in diameter divided by original diameter. The decrease in diameter is L dash minus L, that is nothing but delta D. So lateral strain is equal to delta D by D. And finally, the Poisson's ratio is expressed as lateral strain by longitudinal strain. So the lateral strain is nothing but delta D by D, and longitudinal strain is nothing but delta L by L. So finally, the expression is delta D into L divided by small d into delta L. So this is what Poisson's ratio denoted by symbol sigma. Calculate the force required to produce an extension of 1 millimeter in steel wire of length 2 meter and diameter 1 millimeter if Young's modulus for steel is Y is equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 11 Newton per meter square. So given data is delta L, that is extension produced, is equal to 1 mm, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 meter, and length of the wire L is equal to 2 meter, and the radius R is equal to diameter by 2, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 by 2 meters, and Young's modulus Y is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 11 Newton per meter square. So what is the force required to produce an extension of 1 mm in the steel wire? That means we have to calculate what is F here. So we know the equation for Young's modulus Y is equal to FL by A delta L, where A is area of cross section, that is nothing but pi r square. So F can be written as Y delta L pi r square by L. So substitute the values in the formula, that is 2 into 10 to the power of 11 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into pi into 10 to the power of minus 3 by 2 whole square whole divided by 2. So on simplification, we are going to get the value for F is equal to 78.54 Newton. So this is what the solution for this problem. That means 78.54 Newton, that much force is required to produce an extension of 1 mm in steel wire of length 2 meter. The second problem is calculate the extension produced in a wire of length 2 meter and of radius 0.013 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter due to a force of 14.7 Newton applied along its length, given Young's modulus of the material of the wire, that is Y is equal to 2.1 into 10 to the power of 11 Newton per meter square. So here the length of the wire L is equal to 2 meter, radius is 0.013 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter, and then Young's modulus of the material, that is Y is equal to 2.1 into 10 to the power of 11 Newton per meter square, and the value of force is also be given, that is F is equal to 14.7 Newton, and what is the delta L? So how much extension is going to be produced if that much of force is applied? So we know the formula for Y is equal to FL by A delta L, and the value of area of cross section A is equal to pi r square. So the extension produced delta L is equal to FL by pi r square, that is equal to 14.7 into 2 divided by 2.1 into 10 to the power of 11 into pi into 0.013 into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole square. So on simplification, the value of delta L is equal to 2.64 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter. So this is what the value for delta L, that means 2.64 2.64 into 10 to the minus 3 meter, that much of extension is going to happen in the wire of length 2 meter if the force, that is 14.7 newton, is applied.